did just get introduced. And yeah, all of my experience and activity has been spread so far out across so many varieties of different activities that I can't go up here and say, oh, I did this one cool thing, like I biked all the way through South America. But I'll just give a variety of stories and it'll come together in the end. Like the first time, one of the first times I went camping, I was 7 years old. My dad loaded all of our gear into a canoe, put the canoe on a two-wheel dolly, and pushed the dolly the 16-kilometer trail back and forth from Chequemus Lake. This was a fantastic trip. Chequemus Lake is a glacier-fed lake just a little bit south of Squamish. And the sides of the lake go all the way up, straight into the Alpine. If you've ever skied on Symphony Chair or on Peak Chair on Whistler Mountain, you can actually see down to the lake. Now, being little kids, my dad did most of the hard work of the camping. But we were out every day. We fished our little hearts out. I should just warn you, the pictures have nothing to do with the speech. The pictures are just me being cool. Yeah, so we were out there every day. We fished as much as we could. We didn't catch anything. At one point, we tried to change our luck by paddling across the lake to the far side where not many people go. We were in an old growth forest where the moss was so soft you could walk around barefooted and the trees seemed to be the size of houses. All of this canoeing experience helped me with other canoe trips I'd go on later. In 11th grade, I did a school trip where I, as a strong paddler, was put with one of the weaker paddlers in the group. This girl had never been in a canoe, and even once she was in a canoe, she had very little interest in learning how to canoe. So I paddled as hard as I could to keep up with the group, and we ended up having a pretty swell time anyway, battling through the wind and the waves. I had big arms that summer. The next year, I did another canoe trip that sorta was the same thing. I was a strong paddler. I got put in a boat with a less strong paddler, except that this time we actually had to go up against the wind a couple of the days, battling some great big waves in Anderson Lake. Big crazy adventures. Everybody in that school group knew me as a paddler because I had spent the 2 weeks in May training to become a raft guide. So I'd spent 2 weeks on water every day, traveling around British Columbia out near Lytton, where it's warm and dry, paddling big rivers like the Thompson River and then the Hathlatch River. Growing up in Whistler, I was given many opportunities to do varieties of different sports, as I've said. I competed playing hockey up to a provincial level. I used to race mountain bikes quite a lot. I skied, of course, you know, for Whistler kid. I've done pretty much anything you can do in the mountains. Again, try me. But the one thing that I'd never done was I'd never sailed. I'd never been on the ocean. I mistimed it. This is just skiing. So naturally, after spending 2 weeks in the river raft guiding, I spent 2 weeks racing a sailboat for the first time out on Vancouver Island in the Gulf Islands and out near Victoria. This was an amazing experience. I was thrown onto a boat with a bunch of people who I didn't really know. I still can't remember all of their names. And I had to learn new things every single day, whether it was learning to tie a new knot or whether it was learning a new fancy physics of sailing, which I'm not gonna lie, I don't understand that much. I remember one day coming back from the westernmost point of Washington in Nia Bay, getting woken up just before dawn for my watch. It was my turn to not sleep and sail. So I climb up on deck, I'm all dressed. Somebody hands me a rope, and I, in the middle of the race, at 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning, I was taught how to trim the spinnaker, the big downwind sail. Looks like a plastic bag, they're very pretty. On the sailboat, I had to learn a whole new skill set. Simple stuff like walking, eating, getting dressed, pooping, all of that is incredibly challenging after coming from never having done it before. I'm actually leaving for my first sailboat race of the season tomorrow, and I don't know how it's going to be, but I can tell one thing. It's still April, so it's going to be cold. Speaking of being cold, one of my more recent adventures was to the Marriott Basin, which is just north of Whistler. I was working with an old school group of mine as an assistant guide. All of this time I'd spent on the water and skiing on my own time and raft guiding and stuff had given me so much more experience in the outdoors that my former classmates from the year before and I had a huge difference in skill. I could stay warm all the time and they were always cold. Yeah, so this trip was a very fun experience for me. I got to hang out in the mountains. I skied some pow on my birthday, whereas it rained and all their gear got soaked, and then they were hanging out in a poorly built snow cave and nearly froze to death. You guys get the idea. Bad times. All of this experience in the outdoors has led me to working a job in the outdoors. So what I do is, this winter I started winter ziplining. A normal day on the zip lines is I'll be up on the zip line by 7:15 and I'm shoveling away. And then we ride our first line, which is more than a kilometer long. And because of all the snow on the line, you don't make it, so you have to spin around, pull yourself in and shovel some more. All this experience has led me to be very good at this job because I'm always warm and dry. Unlike a lot of my workmates and friends. I hope they don't see me say that. All of these stories seem to be sort of random little collections of information where, oh, I learned this one thing and then I set it aside and saved it for later. But what I'm really trying to say is all of the adventures that you go on and all the learning that you do on one adventures, learning, eh? You guys don't want to hear that. All the learning that you do builds onto itself and then you can learn more. And all of your adventures will lead to bigger and better adventures. So little adventures turn into big adventures. And if you don't like learning, you're going to learn more and learning gets fun one day. I believe that's all I've got. Ooh, ooh.